take today Unit 2, Lesson 1. That's the last unit in our term. Okay, Lesson 2 in Unit 3 is cancelled. So we will talk today about Lesson 3, Lesson 1, Unit 3, Lesson 1, and Lesson 2 in Unit 3 is cancelled. That's the last lesson in our term. It's talk about soil components. Okay, what is the soil? The soil is, as you can see, that's the soil. And that's the soil, okay? Okay, and also the sand is the soil. Every part of the earth contains the soil, okay? We are walking on the soil of the earth. So the soil is the non-compacted superficial layer that covers the earth's crust. What is the meaning of non-compacted? As you can see, that's the soil. The particles of this soil are non-compacted. What is the meaning of non-compacted? It's not stuck together. They are far away from each other. The particles of the soil are far away from each other. As you can see, the particles, they are non-compacted. They are non-compacted. Let's see what is the meaning of superficial. Okay, let's know what is the meaning of superficial layer. As you can see, that's the earth. Okay, and this layer is called the soil. That's the soil. So the soil is the upper part that covers the earth, or the superficial layer that covers the earth. What is the meaning of superficial? Upper. Okay, so the soil is the non-compacted superficial layer that covers the earth's crust. We live on the earth's crust, and we live also on the soils that cover all the earth. So don't forget, the soil is the non-compacted superficial layer that covers the earth's crust. The soil has many types and many colors. As you can see, all of these are types of soil. These types of soil are different from each other. Why? According to the minerals that the soil consists of. Okay, this soil has a different color from this soil because this soil is consisted of minerals different from this soil, and so on. So the soil has many types, okay, according to the minerals that the soil consists of. And you can see that are types of soils that called clay, okay, and that type of soil is called sand. All of you know the sand. Okay, and we can find the clay or the silt, the soil in the places that we're planting the plant in. Okay, so soil has many types. The soil is made of, or the components of the soil is, if we take a beaker and we put some water in this beaker and we put the soil and stay for a while, we can find that we can find the components of the soil. As you can see, that's the test tube, okay, or the beaker. We fill the beaker with water and we put the soil inside it. Okay, that's the components of the soil. And as you can see, at the end of the test tube or the beaker, there is a gravel. What is the meaning of gravel? Stone, okay? And the upper layer is sand. We all know the sand. That's the sand, okay? And the upper layer is silt, and silt is one of soil types, okay? And all of this is water, and the black points or black particles are clay. And clay also is a type of a soil. And the upper part is the humus, okay? So gravel, sand, silt, clay, and humus. What is the meaning of humus? Humus, it's the decayed remains of dead plants and animals. When plants and animals die, their bodies are decomposed by the decomposers, right? Okay. Decayed meaning decomposed, okay? So this remains when the decomposers decay it or decompose it. This is the humus. Humus is very important to the soil because it provide the soil with its nutrients and gives the soil color, which is dark brown or black. importance of the humus, it gives the soil the nutrients and it gives the soil its color, which is darker brown or black. So don't forget, that's the components of the soil: gravel, sand, silt, clay, and humus. As you can see, humus always at the top of the soil. We know what is the meaning of the soil, and we also know what is the components of the soil. Let's know the importance of the soil. What is the importance of the soil to the plant? You can tell me? Very good. Okay. The roots fix the plant in the soil, and the roots absorb what from the soil? The roots absorb water and the nutrients from the soil. Why? To allow the plant to live and grow. Without the soil, the plant cannot live or the plant cannot grow. The plant needs the soil. We can't plant the plant without the soil? No. So the soil is very important to make the plant grow and live, because the roots absorb water and nutrients from the soil. Number two, some animals feed on the plants that depend on the soil, right? And some animals take from the soil their shelter or their home, like the earthworm, like ants, spiders, and other insects. They take from the soil their shelter or their home. And the last point that we have in the importance of the soil is man. We humans. Humans depend on plants and animals in their food, and plants and animals depend on the soil to live and grow. Now we will talk about the soil layers. We know the components of the soil. Okay? Okay. What is the soil layers that the soil consists of? The soil layers are top soil layer, lower soil layer, rocky layer. Top soil layer, lower soil layer, rocky layer. As you can see, that's the layer of the soil that covers the earth's crust. This layer of the soil consists of three parts: top soil layer, lower soil layer, rocky layer. Top soil layer, lower soil layer, rocky layer. The top soil layer, as you can see, it contains the roots of the plant. And when the leaves of the plant fall on the soil, they fall on the topsoil layer. And the living organisms such as ants, earthworms, spiders, and other insects, they are left in the topsoil layer. Also, the topsoil layer is contained the humus, and also it contains rocks, small rocks. Okay? That's the topsoil layer. Let's talk about the roots of the plant in the topsoil layer. That's the roots of the plant in the topsoil layer. The roots of the plant of the topsoil layer. What is the importance of the soil to the plant? The soil gives what to the plant? Number one, the roots fix the plant in the soil. Number two, the roots absorb water and nutrients from the soil. So, what is the importance of the roots to the soil? What does the roots give to the soil? The roots make the soil cohesive. Cohesive. What is the meaning of cohesive? As I told you, that the soil is not compacted. The particles of the soil are very far from each other, right? Okay. If some wind comes, they will carry the soil to another place. But the plants and the roots make the soil cohesive. It makes the particles of the soil very close to each other. Why? To prevent the soil erosion from happening quickly. What is the meaning of soil erosion? Soil erosion meaning the moving of the soil from one place to other place. I want to plant some plants in this soil. Okay? So I don't want this soil I don't want the erosion to happen to this soil, because I need the soil to planting the plant. The roots make the soil cohesive. It makes the soil above the particles of the soil close to each other. That prevents the soil erosion from happening. We can quickly, and when the roots, when the plant is die, the roots will decay or decompose and form the humus that provides the soil with nutrients. Now we find the roots of the soil in the top soil layer. Now we will talk about the plant's leaves. When the plant's leaves fall on the top soil layer, the plant's leaf will decay or decompose and form the humus that provides the soil with nutrients. And now we will talk about the organisms that live inside the topsoil layer, such as the earthworm, spiders, ants, and other insects. These organisms take from the soil their shelter or home by digging tunnels or making nests. Okay, that's the importance of the soil to these organisms. The soil gives these organisms the shelter or home. But these organisms give what to the soil? What is the importance of these organisms to the soil? Okay, these organisms will die, and when will die, they will decay or decompose and form the humus that provides the soil with nutrients. That's number one. Number two, this living organism live inside the soil by digging tunnels. Okay, when they digging tunnels, they allow the roots to grow inside the soil. Now we finish the topsoil layer. Let's talk about the lower soil layer. The lower soil layer is located under the topsoil layer and it don't have much humus. Let's see. The lower soil layer is located under the topsoil layer and it don't have much humus. Okay, but the top